Hello friends, in this new video we discuss few properties of Fourier transform. The very first property of the Fourier transform is linearity property. If we have two functions f1 of x and f2 of x, then Fourier transform of a into f1 of x plus b into f2 of x, this is equal to a into f1 of s plus b into f2 of s. Fourier transform of the first function plus Fourier transform of the second function. Now remember friend, what is a Fourier transform? Fourier transform is equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s x into f of x into dx. So we write it as a f1 of the first function. Now f2 of s equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s x into second function f2 of x into dx. Now Fourier transform of a into f1 of x plus b into f2 of x equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into a f1 of x plus b f2 of x into dx. Now separating the integral, easily we can write it as a into 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s x f1 of x into dx plus b into 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s x f2 of x into dx. So this is a into capital F1 of S plus b into capital F2 of S. So the Fourier transform is linear. This is the first property of a Fourier transform. Now second property of the Fourier transform is a change of scale. It is called as a change of scale property, change of scale property. So if f of s is Fourier complex Fourier transform, so complex Fourier transform, complex Fourier transform of f of x, then what is that property? Capital F of AX equal to 1 divided by A into capital F of S divided by A. So print Fourier complex transform is 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to ISX into F of X into DX. Then what we have to put here, we have to put f of ax equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into f of ax into dx. Now in this integration we put ax equal to t, then a into dx equal to dt and limit remain unchanged. This is equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I into s into what is x, that is t divided by a into f of t into dx. Dx is dt divided by a. small adjustment, 1 divided by a, 1 divided by under root of 2 pi, integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I into s divided by a into t into f of t into dt. Now look at this term and this term. When we have s is in the power, we write it as a capital F of s, and all other terms are same. Only the difference is of variable. Here variable is x and variable is here t, but the term in the power of e is s divided by a. Therefore we have 1 divided by a into capital F of s divided by a. So whenever the function is f of ax, then the Fourier complex transform will be changed like this, 1 divided by a into f of s divided by a. This is the second property of the Fourier transform. Now see the third property of the Fourier transform, and it is called as a shifting property. Capital F of x minus a equal to e raised to is a into F of s. Once again I am writing here Fourier complex transform, complex Fourier transform e raised to isx into f of x into dx. Now we have to put here f of x minus a. F of x minus a, 1 divided by under root of 2 pi, integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into f of x minus a into dt into dx. Now friend, again we put x minus a equal to t. This implies x equal to t plus a. As x tends to minus infinity, t tends to minus infinity. X tends to plus infinity, t tends to plus infinity. So the limit remain unchanged. F of x minus a into 1 divided by under root of 2 pi, integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s into t plus a into f of t into, here you can see dx equal to dt into dt. Now here if we evaluate this e raised to is into this t plus a, e raised to is is a constant, and therefore we write it as e raised to isa out of this integral, and we get this integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to ist f of t into dt. What is this? This is f of s, and therefore we get e raised to isa into capital F of s. So whenever the function changes x to x minus a, there is an additional terms in the multiplication, that is e raised to I s a. This is the third property of the Fourier transform. Now we have one modulation theorem of this property, Fourier transform, and the modulation theorem is f of x into cos of ax equal to 1 divided by 2 into capital F of s plus a plus capital F of s minus a. Now Fourier complex transform equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi, integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into f of x into dx. Now we have to substitute here f of x into this is f of x. Okay, f of x. Whenever we have f of x, we have here f of x into cos of ax. 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into f of x into cos of ax into dx. Okay, now cos theta equal to e raised to I theta plus e raised to minus I theta divided by 2. Use this formula. 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s x into e raised to I a x plus e raised to minus I a x divided by 2 into f of x into dx. Now 1 by 2 into we are separating the terms. So 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity. Here you can see that isx e raised to iax. Now base is same, so addition of indices I into s plus a into x into f of x into dx. This is the first term. Again 1 divided by under root of 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I into s minus a into x f of x into dx. Okay, so we have separated the integral and you can see that this is nothing but f of s plus a plus this is second term is f of s minus a and this 1 divided by 2. So capital f of x into cos ax we get 1 by 2 f of s plus a of s minus a. This is called as a modulation theorem of the Fourier transforms and this is the fourth property of this modulation theorem. Okay, now next property of this model of this Fourier transform. If f of s equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to I s x into f of x into dx. This is the Fourier complex transform. Now we differentiate this, differentiating with respect to s. Then here d by ds of f of s, d by ds of f of s equal to 1 divided by under root 2 pi. Now you can see that this integral is with respect to x and we are differentiating with respect to s. And therefore, we can write this derivative under the integrand, under the integral, and directly we integrate, differentiate the term which contain s, f of x into dx. So derivative of this with respect to x equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi into here derivative is. I into x integration minus infinity to plus infinity I into x into e raised to isx into f of x into dx. Okay, now here we multiply both side by I, then what we get here I into t by ds of f of s equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi I into I minus, so we get here minus integration minus infinity to x into e raised to isx into f of x into dx. Now transfer this minus side to this side and we write it as minus 1 minus I d by ds of f of s into 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx this x into f of x into dx. Question number 2. Now again differentiate 2 with respect to s, then minus I into d2 by ds square of f of s equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity x into derivative of e raised to isx I x into e raised to isx into f of x into dx. Look at this, again we have I and x into x, x square. So again multiply by I. If we multiply by I, this will be I square and I square is minus 1. So here what we do, we multiply by minus I and minus I into I, that is minus I square. Okay, d2 by ds square into f of s equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi into integration 0 minus infinity to plus infinity x into x, x square e raised to isx into f of x into dx. Equation number 3. Now look at the equation number 2 and 3. Similarly, when we differentiate third time, we get here minus I whole cube. Now continuing this, and we have, if we differentiate with n time, derivative of this ds raised to n f of s, this is equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity x raised to n e raised to I s x f of x into dx. We get this term, and this is our next property or fifth property of this integration of this Fourier transform. See what is a minus I into raised to n nth derivative of f of s equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity x raised to n into e raised to isx f of x into dx. This is the fifth property of the Fourier transform. Now next property of the Fourier transform, so here you can see we write it as this is equal to where f of x raised to n into f of x equal to minus I raised to n into s raised to n f of s. This is the fifth property of the Fourier transform. Okay, next property of the Fourier transform, capital F of f dash of x equal to I into s into f of s if f of x tends to 0 as x tends to plus or minus infinity. Again write this as f dash of x equal to Fourier transform integral 1 divided by under root of 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to ixx into f dash of x into dx. Okay, so this is my first function, this is second function. Let us evaluate this. 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity we are evaluating, so no need to write the integral and we directly integrate this. Integration first function as it is, first function e raised to isx into integral, derivative and integral get cancelled, minus integration of derivative of the first e raised to isx into is into integral of the second f of x into dx. This is between the limit minus infinity to plus infinity. Now see here, at plus and minus infinity f of x tends to 0. So at upper limit as well as at lower limit, this is 0. And this is equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi. We have minus I into s integration minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into f of x into dx. This is our f of s. So this is equal to minus I into s into f of s minus I into s. Okay. So in the statement we have small here is minus I into s into f of x. So whenever we are calculating the Fourier transform of the derivative, then we have to multiply this by minus I into s. This is the property of the Fourier integral, Fourier transform. Okay. Now next property of the Fourier transform is Fourier transform of e raised to iax into f of x equal to f of s plus a. It is quite simple. F of e raised to iax into f of x equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to isx into e raised to iax into f of x into dx equal to 1 divided by under root of 2 pi integration minus infinity to plus infinity I into s plus a into x into f of x into dx. And this is nothing but capital F of s plus a. This is very simple. So this is the shifting property. Whenever we multiplied by e raised to iax f of x, we have to write it as capital F of s plus a. So these are the properties of the Fourier transforms. So friend, I hope you have enjoyed this. Thank you for watching the video.